dance. I am a can of whoop ass ready to open. I really wish these niggas would stop fronting on me.
Niggas try to front, we move on them. Niggas think something sweet till we move on them, yeah.
What's up, people? WWE 2K14 game play back on deck, and in my perfect world, the only team that will be able to take out the Shield is the team that pretty much ran the 90s for WCW and got them ratings up in the Monday Night War. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, I am talking about the NWO, New World Order. That's right. Got Big Sexy Kevin Nash in the ring. Got Scott Hall and the Man Six Pop. Now, I didn't mean to be posting up a whole lot of wrestling this week, but being that the pay-per-view is coming up Sunday, I figured let me drop something. I had another scenario in mind of how the Elimination Chamber should go as far as like one of the matches. And y'all know that match is going to be the Wyatt family versus the Shield. Now, back when Daniel Bryan was in the mix with the Shield on Raw, they had a Wyatt family come out and get involved, and they had like a standoff. Wyatt family and the Shield. You know, they teased it. The crowd went crazy. The crowd was hyped. I said, all right, they got something there. And then they ain't go to it no more. And I was like, man, WWE always dropping the ball when they got something that's organic, that's so hot, and they just don't run with it. So now they finally get to it a couple of weeks ago. You know, they had a match with the Shield versus John Cena, Daniel Bryan, and Sheamus. And the winner team were going to be in Elimination Chamber with Randy Orton and whatever winner team won on SmackDown. But while the match is going on, the Wyatt family comes out, attack John Cena. So, of course, when the guys come out, attack the person, whoever the victim is, they win. So, of course, they win. Shield pissed. Roman Reigns standing on top of the announce table, looking at Bray Wyatt, screaming, "This our yard, this our yard." You know, they the hounds of justice. And then the next week, out comes the Shield. They want to call out the Wyatt family. You know, they want some revenge. Triple H comes out. And Triple H trying to be all diplomatic and not telling, you know, Shield, you know, this ain't really what you want. But the funny thing is, the Shield being Triple H's enforcers, the whole time the authority been in effect. But now all of a sudden, this ain't what you want. Something fishy going on. So Roman Reigns like, yo, we ain't asking you for no match. We telling you we want a match. But Triple H like, you know what? Alright, that what y'all want? That's what y'all get. So now I'm thinking of this scenario. Thinking Triple H got something to do with the Wyatt family. Come the Elimination Chamber. I feel like the Wyatt family's gonna pull this out. Either way, it's gonna be a win-win for the Shield. The Wyatt family pulls this off. It won't be a clean victory. I think Triple H is gonna get involved somehow. It cost the Shield the match. And with the rumors of Roman Reigns going against Triple H, this would be the perfect way to set that up. So you get Triple H coming out, somehow interfering with the match, giving the Wyatts the victory. The following night on Raw, which is the night that the WWE Network premieres, you know, the Shield call out the Wyatt family don't come out, Triple H come out, trying to be all diplomatic again. That's when Roman Reigns say, you know what? If you want to step in the ring and get involved in people's matches, why don't you just step in the ring? And pretty much call Triple H out and get a match. That'd be perfect. And then it'd be Triple H versus Roman Reigns. And Triple H, you know, does the job. Get Roman Reigns over. Super over than he is already. That'd make him a superstar. Like I said, that would be perfect in my perfect world. But this is the WWE. And you know, sometimes they get storylines and stuff. It's real, real hot. And instead of running with it to end it cold turkey, and it's something that they should have ended cold turkey to keep on dragging on. But that's all I got. Just want to give y'all my ideas. I like coming up with these dream matchups and coming up with these scenarios and thinking I'm always plotting on what the WWE gonna do next and what they should do next. And I'm gone. This is SlickJC, you're the Toys B.I.G., brother in gaming. Bring y'all that hot WWE 2K14 and how I would have done it. I'm out. Peace.
This is going to return to the ring. What's he going to do here? What's he going to do here? Without a doubt, probably one of the most dangerous matches in all of the WWE. What a beating! What a beating being dished out here by Scott Hall! And now he's back out on the apron. Without a doubt, probably one of the most dangerous matches in all of the WWE. At stake for these teams in this match. A win in this one is absolutely huge. And that punch lands hard. And that punch lands hard. Look out. Now what in the pig? Whoa! Whoa, right on target. He makes the tag. And he finally gets out of the ring. Victory here tonight. Man, oh man, what a battle!
Thank y'all for watching. Hope y'all found that funny. Hope y'all found that entertaining. If you did, retweet the link. Share it on your Facebook, your Tumblr, your Instagram, your Vine. Call your mama. Call your daddy. Call your grandmama. Call your cousin. Call everybody. Show the people at work. Let them know. Spread the love. All right, y'all. Peace.